it's those small moments that are really special. And if you see the table moving around, it's because I'm excited. My legs are doing this. Welcome back, and thank you for joining me for another reaction video. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, hang on a second, that's a different background. Or even possibly, hey dude, you don't have your glasses on. Or, better yet, Chase, you're giving off more of an American vibe. Well, you'd be right on all accounts, because I've officially moved to the good old US of A, and I now call Arizona home. But I don't have my PC or my setup here yet, so I have hijacked the other harps. So thank you, B. Love you loads. She's been gracious enough to lend me her setup in the meantime. So if there's any tweaks I need to make, give me some time, be a bit patient. And I thought, what better way to celebrate my first video in the US than to say hi to the neighbors? So we're back with a warning, and I am super jacked about this one. A lot of people asking for this, particularly the live version. So here we go. The warning, choke, live session. Let's see what you got. I won't say goodbye in the end. Matter at all, I'm sure. I won't survive the fall. Okay, hot minute. Now, let me talk to you. I'm really happy that I had a look at a live song from them. For anyone who knows me and knows why I've avoided looking at the warning for a long time, it wasn't for any particular reason. The fans were a bit intense, but everyone seems to be really kind and loving these reactions, so thank you for the support. But yeah, I think someone played me something a long time ago, and I was like, yeah, it's pretty cool, but I didn't quite latch onto it. And then I did my first reaction a couple months back and absolutely loved it. So I was like, I got to do more. And here we are. I love that I did a live version. So thank you so much for asking me to do that, because that's like when I latch onto a band and I get a feel for what I like from them, I want to know they can do it live. And it's never quite the same. And it shouldn't be. It really shouldn't be. But man, the quality of what they're doing, it is a very, very simple song. The vocals, not so much. The vocals are quite powerful and, to be honest, quite intricate, especially with the backing vocals. But who am I to say? I'm no vocal coach. Musically, it's quite simple, but it's spot on. It feels raw and live, and it feels fully controlled. Every note feels purposeful. It feels really like it's a confident playing session. And I always worry when there's a single guitarist how they're going to fill the gap between lead work and some of that rhythmic element. You talk about a musical canvas and how they're going to fill it with all the colors. Well, turns out the bass is doing an extraordinary job here. Extraordinary. And I love the tone on the bass. Massive fan. I will say this, however. I could do with a bit more guitar in terms of volume. Whenever you get these live sessions, it's almost perfect, and it certainly is of a high quality, but I could do with a little bit more low end on the guitar or a bit more volume, saying that the low end would contradict with the bass and some of the tom work. So the balance is great, but yeah, maybe I'm just a guitarist looking for more of what I do. This is awesome, man. This is great. Loving it. Oh, all of this, feels right. Hang on. I want to hear you too. Easy. Give your boy a minute. I've spoken a lot about how you can find a lot of beauty in simplicity. And it's not because things that are simple are beautiful. It's because the simplicity of them allows you to notice the things around them. And when something is predictable on the count, quite a simple chord structure, that power chord, bar chord, just kind of build up, drop down, the vocals somewhat rhythmically mimic that, the drums are doing enough to like let you know when the phrasing is going to start and end and change into different parts, the vocals outstanding, but just little after every little chord hit in the verse, there's one or two little pick pieces and you can hear the bass doing kind of a hop between the two notes. It's those small moments that are really special. And if you see the table moving around, that's because I'm excited. My legs are doing this. Also, I realized in the beginning of the video, I said I wasn't wearing my glasses and implied that somehow moving to America has fixed that. It hasn't. But with the lighting she's got, too much glare, I just look like I'm being abducted by aliens. So can't have it. I'll have to figure it out. Simplicity. And sometimes when you have the ability to sketch the most intricate and detailed real life portrait, the power and control it takes to not, I like that. Yeah. Yep. Yipsy daisies. I love it. I'm gonna listen to a whole lot more of that. I'm really tempted in these moments to go and quickly listen to the chorus of that as a recorded song, because I do feel like in that one, if I was gonna be critical of anything, and God, who am I to criticize anything? And it's not being critical. It's more of just something that I prefer. It's a taste preference. I really like when there's a little more fullness to the distortion and it feels a little bit closer to me in the mix. But it's a great hook, man. It's a great song, simple song. And I think this was like exactly where I needed to go with them. Did the previous song. And I always say to myself, like, if I like something, I want to have a look at a live version of what they can do, because it really does give you the context. I'm clicking through here and I'll tell you why. Because, let me find it real quick. Basically, the other reason I'm probably not going to go and click through to a recorded version is because I do tend to have quite a lot of issues with copywriting. This channel is not monetized yet, even though I'm in the US. I probably will only be able to turn monetization on in like February or March. Hopefully sooner than that, but you never know. And I do see that the last one I did, a song called More, it was partially blocked and has a copyright claim. So I don't want to risk it. It's something that is heartbreaking when you put together a reaction and you want to show people and you have to like delay it or, God forbid, not release it at all. I have a few of those. And but yeah, so we'll leave it there. But I am super keen to get stuck into more. And if you do have any that you'd like me to look at, please, 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 please let me know. And guide me. I trust you guys. So far, so good. Give me something different now. It doesn't necessarily need to be an extreme. It doesn't have to be an acoustic or a really heavy one. It can be. But tell me from a listening point of view, if you had to start your The Warning journey over again, where would I go next? I put my future in your hands. Until the next one, please be safe, be nice to each other, never dare. Good day.